What a game between the Packers and Cardinals. 51-45 in overtime. Cards get it done. Finally, some excitement over Wild Card Weekend. Before that game, the weekend was about as entertaining as Charles Barkley on Saturday Night Live. What do you mean I need acting lessons? With the Jets, Cowboys, and Ravens all winning in non-nail-biting fashion, we needed a good barn burner. Thankfully, the Pack and Cards didn't disappoint. This game had everything. A ton of offense. The teams combined for 96 points and 62 first downs. Hello! There was a very memorable play to end the game. Plus, you had controversy. Larry Fitzgerald did his Dick Butkus impression running over an opponent before scoring a touchdown. He actually did it twice, one more blatant than the other. No call on either. Bertrand Barry of the Cards had a helmet-to-helmet hit on Aaron Rodgers in overtime. No call. And on the final play of the game, Michael Adams, who had been horrible, horrible, horrible all game long, finally made a huge play. He sacked and stripped Aaron Rodgers of the ball. Carlos Dansby picked it up, ran for a touchdown, but he had a little face mask action. Grabbed a little face mask. No call. Packer fans are livid. This won't make the green and gold feel any better, but sometimes controversy makes playoff games that much more memorable. Think about some of the playoff games that are in NFL lore because of controversy. The Immaculate Reception, the Tuck Rule, the Music City Miracle. I'm not saying this controversy was on the same level as those controversies, but the bottom line is, when there's ever disagreements between fans, it's gonna make the game that much more memorable. One thing I'd like to say real quick about overtime, though. How often do you hear people complain about the overtime rules in the NFL? Saying, it's not fair. We didn't get the ball. We lost the toss and it's just not fair. In the NFL, you make things fair. If you don't win the toss, you bring your defense and you shut your mouth. That's it. Cardinals didn't win the toss after it was tied 45 apiece going into overtime. The Cardinals made a defensive play and ended up winning the game. That's what you do. This isn't Little League. We're not handing out orange slices to both teams after the game. It's not everybody gets an equal opportunity. If you don't win the toss, you bring your defense. And that's it. This is sudden death. This is a man's game. So please, the next time you hear some pathetic person whining about the NFL overtime rule, it's not fair. Point to this game and say the Cards didn't win the toss against the Packers. They made a defensive play. They deserve to win the game. It might take a lot more controversy for the Cards to beat the Saints next week. Coming off a short week, the Cards hit the road to take on the Saints in New Orleans after they just gave up 45 points and a ton of yardage to the Packers. How are they going to fare against the Saints? Might get a little breezy in New Orleans. But the Cardinals did score 51 points and gained a ton of yardage against the number 2 ranked defense. So we'll see what happens. One thing I do know for sure, hopefully the remaining games in the playoffs are as memorable as this Packers-Cardinals game. I'm Brian Noe, and that's a no-brainer.